Hello, welcome back to the lecture 2 of Microcontroller and its application. In today's lecture, we will discuss about the architecture of 8051. So you can see on your desktop the architecture of 8051. It's a very simple architecture. In the architecture of 8051, you can see towards your left top corner, there is an arithmetic and logic unit. Your 8051 has an 8-bit arithmetic and logic unit. It has a register A and register B. Below it you can see register A and register B. Register A is nothing but it's an 8-bit accumulator. Register B is just a register, is just an 8-bit register which complements your accumulator in doing arithmetic operations. Then you have a program status word towards its right. PSW, register PSW, which is again an 8-bit register which contains your flags as well as some your register select bits. We'll study that in detail later. You have a special function register. Special function registers, there are around 34 special function registers in 8051 which are used to configure your microcontroller for various operations such as input output operation, timer operation, serial communication operation. So you have special function registers for that. The most important function is your 8051 has an 8-bit data bus and a 16-bit address bus. And your 8051 has four ports. It has port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3, as you can see towards the right. And each port has a latch. What is a latch? A latch is a device which will hold the last value that was returned to the port. And unless and otherwise you reset your microcontroller, or unless and otherwise you overwrite the data will remain there. So each port has its latch. So each port in 8051 is 8-bit port. And each port can either act as an input port or an output port based upon how you configure it. How we configure it, we'll see later on in input-output programming lecture. And each port, apart from being as an input and output port, it has a multiple function. Like port 0, apart from being used as an input or output port, it can also be used, it is also multiplexed with higher order address and data lines. Port 1 does not have any multiplex function. Port 2 can be used for higher order address lines. And then port 3 can be used for, is multiplexed with interrupt and serial communication bits. And your 8051, most important, has an internal RAM of 128 bytes and an internal ROM of 4 kilobytes, which helps you to, which that is one reason why it is called a system on chip, because it has its own memory. You need not attach external RAM and ROM unless and otherwise it is required. Then it has some system and timing signals, like you have external access pin, which is used to access, which when grounded you can access an external memory. You have address latch enable, which is used to demultiplex your address and data lines, lower order address and data lines. You have program store enable, which is used to invoke an external ROM that is connected to 8051. You have crystal oscillator pins. You have reset pin to reset your microcontroller to its initial state. You have VCC and ground pin to power your microcontroller. And then your internal RAM is divided into three different types of memory structure. That is, it is divided as a register bank, bit addressable registers, and general purpose registers. We will be looking at it in detail in the lectures to follow. So this is a basic simple architecture of 8051. We look at the programming model of 8051. As you can see on the screen, what you see on the screen, for example here the register A, what you can see over there is on the left is the how many bit wide this register is. Okay, and what you see on the right is the address of this register. That is, accumulator register is 8-bit wide and it has the address E0. That is what this notifies. And apart from this, this asterisk mark that you find being notified here denotes that it is a bit addressable register. So accumulator is a register which is 8-bit wide, it has an address E0 and it is bit addressable register. Similarly, you have register B, you have various registers for interrupt and timers. For timer configuration, you have TMOD and timer control, timer mode register. You have timer high and timer low registers. You have serial control registers, serial buffer register, and you have power control register, program status word. Each register's data, how much bit wide it is written towards its left, and its address is written towards its right. There is a stack pointer register in 8051. The stack pointer register is just 8 bit wide, and it has an address 81. And as you can see, data pointer register in 8051 is 16 bit wide. It is divided into two parts, that is DPH and DPL. Now, DPH is its higher byte and DPL is its lower byte, that is data pointer high and data pointer low, each 8 bit wide, and each has different address location. That is, DPH has an address location 83 and DPL has an address location 82. But data pointer DPTR as together can be addressed or together can be programmed also. As you can notice, program counter is again a 16-bit address, 16-bit register, but it does not have any address. You cannot control it. It is used by your system. It is used by your microcontroller. So apart from this, you have each port. Ports, there are special function register for 4, port 0, port 1, port 2, and port 3, and each of these ports have their address also, and their bit address. Means each port pin can be used as an either input or for an output function. And as you can see towards my left, you can find the general purpose registers, the register banks. After the register banks, there are four register banks: register bank 0, register bank 1, register bank 2, register bank 3. This is the configuration of your internal RAM. After the register bank, you have bit addressable area. After the bit addressable area, you have general purpose area. So your internal ROM starts is a 4 kilobyte internal ROM. You have hexadecimally the address starts from 000 to FFF. So even your internal ROM is represented here. You can see that very clearly. So this is the programming model. Programming model states which all registers are available for you to program, what is, how many bits wide they are, and what is their addresses. So it will be easy for you to program. So let's move ahead. This is a pin diagram of 8051. The pin diagram shows how many, it has 40 pins, and the diagram shows a 40 pin dual inline package. And as you can see, most of the pins in 8051 have dual purposes. This is used so that the footprint of the microcontroller can be as minimal as possible to make the hardware cost less and make it more efficient. As we discussed the specific features of 8051, it is an 8-bit CPU with an 8-bit accumulator and 8-bit register B. It has 16-bit program counter and data pointer. It has a program status word and a stack pointer. It has internal ROM and a RAM, and it has a RAM of 128 bytes. It has a ROM of 4 kilobytes internally. It has 32 bits or 32 pins of 8-bit ports. Okay, so port 0 to port 3, there are 4 ports. It has two 16-bit timers, T1 and T0. It has full duplex serial data transmitter and receiver, and it has a controlled registers. For example, for serial communication and timer operation, you know, you have controllers like TCON, TMOD, serial communication. You have SCON, SBUF, and all this. Then it has two external and three internal interrupt services. We'll be seeing that in detail in the classes to come. And it has oscillator and clock circuits. So as you can see, the oscillator circuit and timing. Each machine cycle in 8051 has 12 pulses. Each machine cycle has 12 pulses, and for every 2 pulse is defined with a state. Every 2 pulses is defined with a state. So there are 6 states for one machine cycle. What is most important for us to take away from this is timing of an instruction is calculated as each timing or time required for one instruction is calculated by this formula, as you can see, where C is the number of machine cycles required to do that instruction or execute that instruction, multiplied by 12, D represents decimal, divided by crystal frequency. Now crystal frequency can vary from 1 to 20 megahertz, 1 to 16 megahertz for the 8051 microcontroller. So whatever is the crystal frequency, most preferable crystal frequency used, along with 8051 is 11.0592 megahertz. But any crystal frequency from 1 to 60 megahertz can be used, and depending upon the crystal frequency and the number of machine cycles, we can decide, we can know how much time instruction is required for operation. You can see the program status word register. Program status word register has 8 bits again. So you can see it has flags. It has flags, carry flag, auxiliary carry flag. It has the user flag F0. Then it has overflow flag and parity flag. Now it has 4 flags like carry flag, auxiliary carry, overflow and parity, which represents the status of the system or the operation that is going on in your microcontroller. So you know how a carry flag is generated. Whenever there is an overflow in arithmetic operation, a carry flag is generated, or when there is a borrow and subtract operation, a carry flag is generated. You know, when an auxiliary carry flag is generated, an auxiliary carry flag is generated. When there is an carry over from lower nibble to higher nibble, and F0 is a user flag. You can decide its operation, when it should be set and when it should not be set. And overflow flag, as you know, it actually notifies errors if you have, and when your stack overflows, when your memory will overflow beyond its maximum limit, it notifies an error. Now, and parity flag, you know, is to notify whether your number is an even parity or odd parity, and its application is in error detection and correction. That is program status word. And you can see the stack operation. You have a 8-bit stack pointer in 8051. Stack occupies your internal RAM memory, and well, your stack operates in a very simple fashion. That is, whenever you operate on the stack, whenever you use an instruction called push, you push a data from your accumulator into the top of the stack. So you decide where to push from the data from the accumulator. You can decide where to push. You can decide where to push the data. So push makes a data from a register to go to the top of the stack, and pop takes the data from the top of the stack and takes back to the register that is denoted in the operand of pop instruction. So push will push the data from a register to the top of the stack, and pop will push the data from the top of the stack to a register. Registers are mostly addressed by the direct addressing mode in push and pop instruction. So stack is that. Okay. So that brings us to the end of this lecture. I hope you have followed the 8051 architecture. It is very simple. It has very simple functions. All you need to know is go through it, and you will understand it very clearly. The features are very simply laid out. Please go through it and revert back if you have any doubt.